I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, it won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. Got every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. You know, we're just so excited to be in the presence of the Lord here today. Amen. Just glorifying the name of the Lord, lifting up his holy name, knowing that he is so great, he is so wondrous. Amen. That he is a wonder and a wonderful Savior. I just want to bless your heart today and bless your life with the word of God and the word of knowledge, the word of wisdom. You know, God is not finished with you yet. Amen. You know, I've known that to be pretty much a slogan. Amen. And that's just a process of time of God working and in your life. You know, I want to share with you that God has those great and mighty promises. Amen. And he wants you to hang on those things. Hang on the faith. Hang on the love. Hang on the hope. Hang on the things that are righteous. Hang on those things that are just. Hang on those things that is a blessing in and for your life. Because he does love you so, so very much. Hallelujah. You know, many of y'all may be feeling down and out today. Amen. This is a week, the week of process. Amen. This past Sunday was the Psalm Sunday, amen, the Palm, with the entry, you know, of our Lord and our precious Savior, that let everything that has breath to praise the name of the Lord. But in the process of that entry, he knew that it was time. It was time of the Savior to be crucified. The time of the end had is drawn near to a new beginning. Amen. And that's the way the Lord is working as well in our lives. You know, when we believe that, well, it's all finished, it's all done. In our reality, God is creating new things. You know, new portions of new places and new spaces that we can go into. It's all in the knower. It's all in our belief. It's all in our system of knowing and believing, and as well as receiving that which God has already ordained, that which God has already given to you. You need the revelation of that. You need the revelation of the word of who you are in him and all that he's called you out to be. I believe that the Lord weeps, in a sense, for his children just for the foreknowledge of them not knowing of all and who they are and the capabilities that his power and that his anointing and that his placement has given unto us. Because if we know who you are, then you know what you can do. When you know what you have, there is nothing at a distance that will not draw near to you. You know, I wanted to talk to you about the authority. Because knowing who you are, me, even as a mother to my three children that live underneath my roof, if I didn't take my place as a mother, I would not have much authority. But God sees what I see myself as a mother allows me in my right place and my right mind to bless my children, to grant my children, to lift up my children, because he has placed me the authority figure, the speaker, the one that's anointed that I can lay hands even upon my children to show them, to lead them, to guide them into the directions where they should go and to whom they shall follow. I pray that they as well may be as the sheep that chooses to hear God's voice, to make a decision to have him as Lord and as a Savior. My believer, my knower, says yes, they belong to the Lord. But does that give me a Holy Ghost right not to speak to them, not to minister to them, not to lift them up, not to do those things that Christ is encouraging each and every one of us not only to do, but do we not want someone to encourage us, to bring an enlightenment to where we're at and to where we can go? That there is that hope for the future. There is that hope for the mind. There is that hope in our spirit, in our knowing that God is drawing near and that he is coming soon. And not only is he coming for grown-ups and elders, but those that choose to believe, and also not only believe, but to receive the Lord Jesus Christ within our lives. Do not belittle the young children, for the Lord said, let my children come. Come, ye all, my little children. We do not want to push not one away. We do not want to anger them easily, that they may honor the father, the mother, those that are in leadership, those that are elders, not only in the church, but in our house, in the highways, in the byways. Teach to honor and to respect, that they may live a very, not only a long life, but a prosperous life in the Lord. Keep heed. Stand still and know that Jesus Christ is Lord. They have their own way, just like we have our own way. That's why we ask the Lord to not only give us the words, but give us the anointing to break the yoke of bondages, to set the captive free, to give them righteous and right minds. Not that we draw away, but that we draw near, just as those that wanted to come to Christ. So we take heed and know that what God has done, he has done a great deal. And there is that favor, and there is that kindness, and there is that love, and there is that oneness. So be blessed today, church. Let us have not only a teachable spirit, but a learnable spirit. We are all called, but few are chosen. Let us be discipled into the things of the Lord until ye yourself carry thee of the Lord. Let us not be prideful. Let us not be boisterous. But may we humble ourselves before the great and mighty King. God bless you today, church. We love you. Thank you for crossing these borders with a voice of alert, cruzando fronteras, con una voz alerta, with me, and challenging to be that example of the Lord. Take time this week. Take time this week to minister to your children. Take time this week to minister to your loved ones. Invite them to church. Invite them to an event that can literally change their lives forever. If you are not going to church, I invite you to visit the Potter's House of Fort Worth in this great metroplex of Fort Worth, Texas. They'll be doing a one service at 10 a.m. And it will be Easter, a day of resurrection program of I Am. Hallelujah. The Kids Age group will gather together as well. And I believe it's from age 3 to age 12 to 13. So gather your children, gather your loved ones, and if you say, I don't have a place to go to, let me know, and I'll send you that address, or easily be able to log on to, once again, the Potter's House of Fort Worth. God bless you. Share this word. Be encouraged and be enlightened. Jesus is the Lord. Blessings again. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.